Thank you, Bix. Thanks, Robert. What a great start. I just realised I do have to say something to the people in TV land. My name's Ed Sullivan. Simon Hughes. I'm the head of music for performance in the school. And I believe we have a few people dialing in this evening. Welcome to this evening's Twilight Soiree, the first live concert with a live audience that we've had for 2 years. And I'll say a few words about that through the evening. Thank you, Bix, for that start. Bix is one of our HSC students. That's an exploration of different styles and the different colours on the drum kit, and that will be his performance core in his HSC later in the year. So without further ado, I think we'll bring Jake and Gail up onto stage to get ready for their performance. So today, we decided that Gail decided that we were going to do the accompaniment live because Jake could play it. And we haven't had that vibe in the music department for a very long time. The kids were jamming when we with their mask on, Mrs. Adamson, when we were doing our tests this morning. And Jake just played it. So instead of a backing track, Gail's now going to sing it live with Jake. Jake, could you just play a couple of chords, make sure we got our levels? And Jake and Gail are both new to the music program. They came here last year, I think, but we didn't have a lot on last year, and we're excited to have them in the program. And please welcome again as Gail sings Cherry Wine. Yeah? So Sam is going to sing a bit of Stevie Wonder for us this evening, My Cherie Amour. Just before she starts, I just want to acknowledge Robert Narlan, who played with Bix. Robert cares a great deal for all his students, and he's been mentoring Bix a great deal lately to get him ready for his HSC performances, and he helped Bix compose that piece for drums. So can we just give him a quick round of applause, please? And we've got Robbie started a drum CCA, doing some world drumming as well. So please now welcome the wonderful, wonderful Sam Tan to sing Stevie Wonder for us. Did you just bow? Did she bow? I missed it. You can see it's written all over Sam's face just how passionate she is about music. It is a very important part of her being, and that was beautiful, Sam. Thank you so much. I am now going to pause before we bring the trumpets up, I think it is next. Is that right? And I have a message. Brad Bird, our boss in the secondary school, is a very trusting person because he's written me some text to read out on his behalf. I'm not sure whether to try and mimic his voice or just read it faithfully. But in all seriousness, Brad is very disappointed he couldn't be here tonight, and I think he may be in TV land. He's in Sydney doing a principal's course, and it's training that they have been waiting to do for a lot of years, and it's important training for our school and for them professionally. And there will be other opportunities. But Brad asked me to read this out to you all. Good evening, all. Unfortunately, I am in Sydney attending a principal's course, but wanted to be with you tonight. I want to acknowledge and wish everyone performing tonight the very best of luck and a massive thank you. I hope you never lose the passion for music as we look to build back our wonderful music program. I particularly want to thank our incredibly talented and passionate music staff for their perseverance and dedication during the last couple of years. It has taken its toll, but the positive determination that has come from the team has been, and I'm not sure about his choice of words here, infectious. I guess we've got that in our minds at the moment. Now, I just can't quite read this bit. I hope you all enjoy tonight, and may we have one or two more events in 2022 as we get the rules straight. Thank you, Brad, for those words. Thank you, Mr. Bird. And I'd like to thank Adam Patterson, who's here tonight, our head of the whole school, and Mrs. Jo Adamson, who is our compliance officer and has one of the worst jobs in the school in the last 2 years, being the fun police. And it's so nice to have her here and to be sitting in listening to some live music. So thank you. We're going to bring Grace and Daria up now to play. And I just wanted to say, if you've looked at the program, you'll notice, come on up, girls, and we'll set up while I bang on about really interesting things. So really, tonight's program is a bit of a roller coaster of love, heart-wrenching loss, and a dollop of marriage reflection, which is the next piece. It's called Married Life. And if we take that metaphor a little further, listening to music is a very personal and abstract experience. However, this piece has a bit of a carnival-like feel to it. So if you reflect on your own strong relationships or marriages, it's a carnival-like with the odd bit of dissonance, resolved with consonants, the odd antecedent statement, then the consequence of the answer of that statement, and generally one of extreme happiness, I think. So the girls have worked very hard on this, and it's so nice to have Daria, who's new at the school this year, a trumpet buddy for Grace. They can push each other, and I know it's going to push them to practice all the time. They're going to be playing scales and more scales and more scales. Now, before they play this piece, Dr. Fontecha, they found this online, despite Mr. Elliott providing quite an expansive library to Grace of trumpet duets by tried and tested Western composers. Daria and Grace found this duet online on a MuseScore site, and Dr. Fontecha decided that she was going to write a little accompaniment for it, and it's really one of those beautiful village moments. The girls have practiced really hard. Dr. Fontecha, who we're very grateful, works with us now in our music village, put it together, and I hope you enjoy it. Please welcome them.
Thank you.
Well done, girls. That's the best you've played it. I don't mean that facetiously. It really is. We've finally got a live audience where we've got the X Factor coming back, where the kids can be in front of an audience and they just lift. And it was really good in their last rehearsal, so please don't get me wrong. That was not a facetious comment. And how thoughtful, Grace. You left the stand for me. Grace is one of our olden days performers. She's been with us since she was tiny. And I had a moment with all of the students this morning when we were doing our PET testing, our pre-event testing. And we were sitting in Music Room 4 and we all had it organised and Grace came and she's sitting there. I said, okay, Grace, I had to supervise it. You put up your nose and okay, I know, sir, I've done it before. And I just paused for a moment. I thought, Grace, who'd have thought that 3 years ago someone said, you and I are going to be sitting in a room and I was going to be encouraging you to swab the inside of your nose and explore your nasal passages. You just wouldn't believe it, right? It just is a reminder of how our world has turned upside down in the last 2 years. And on that note, it is amazing the resilience that our students have displayed through that time. It is infectious, to quote Mr. Bird. They have managed to weather some pretty amazing challenging moments, and we had all our home-based learning, and now there's a glimmer of we're starting to live with this as an endemic. You know, from our window in the staff room, I swear I saw an outside sporting team playing our AIS people the other day. That felt normal. Our outdoor education program is potentially going off-site. We're sitting in the theatre listening to live music. We need to be cautious and we need to follow the rules and we need to respect them, but we can work within them now and that's super exciting. Now, speaking of the olden days, Clarice, when she was in year 7, I think, sung her first solo with the choir at Foundation Day in the gym, I think, Clarice? Yeah, Foundation Day in the gym years ago. And her lingering memory of that was Josh Spratt, who's the photo in the program. Oh yeah, Josh really stuffed his solo up. Not that she sang the solo with the choir and that it was the most amazing moment.
It was the most amazing moment.
I loved it. But Josh messed up.
But it is appropriate. It is very appropriate. We've got Clarice, Nick and Emma tonight who are from our big choral program and were hugely important to us before this pandemic. And they're not doing elective music. They have other academic pathways. So we're now in a place where we can invite them up as well. And I was so rapt that they decided to come and sing for us. And Clarice, I'm still reflecting on other things other than hearts that you might keep in jars. Some sort of medical specimen.
What else could you keep
in don't jars? Know. I hope I haven't ruined the vibe. But we're back with love after our reflection of our respective marriages. Thank you.
Take one more step towards you, 'cause all that's waiting is regret. And don't you know I'm not your ghost anymore? You lost the love I loved the most. I learned to live half a life. Now you want me one more time. Who do you think you are? Running around leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul. So don't come back for me. Who do you think you are? I hear you're asking all around if I am anywhere to be found. That I have grown too strong to ever fall back in your arms. you want me one more time? Who do you think you are? Running round, leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul. So don't come back for me. And it took so long just to feel alright. Remember how to put back the light in my eyes. I wish I had missed the first time that we kissed, 'cause you broke all your promises. Now you're back, get me back. Who do you think you are? Running around, leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul. So don't come back for me. Don't come back at all. Running round, leaving scars, collecting your jar of hearts, tearing love apart. You're gonna catch a cold from the ice inside your soul. Don't come back for me. Don't come back at all. Who do you think you
Well done, Clarice. We had to have a lesson in bowing this afternoon. We've forgotten lots of things. I'm really grateful that Emma's singing tonight. Emma, I can't remember what year. I think it was 2017 when we did a couple of pieces with Junior Jazz Band and she sang with them. She was one of our soul band backup singers. She had solos in the choir. She was in our VE group. Emma is a very impressive young student. She's academic, she's sporty, she understands service, and she loves music. Music is a real part of her. And she's an example of one of the students where this was just torn away by the last 2 years. And I think in her year 10, that cohort that was in year 12, we've had two cohorts that have really missed out on all of this. And I'm so pleased that Emma and Clarice and Nick and the others, we're back. And I know I'm banging on about this, but this is really a very special signpost moment for us as a music department. So I will continue to bang on about it. So let's welcome Emma to the stage to sing Turning Tables, yeah? Is your...
Thank you.
will never be knocked down. I can't keep up with your turning tables under your thumb. I can't breathe. I won't let you close enough. I'm to say goodbye to tyrant and table. Tyrant and table. Next time I'll be braver. I'll be my own savior when the thunder calls to me. Time I'll be braver, I'll be my own savior, standing on my own two feet. I won't let you close enough to hurt me. No, I won't rescue you to just desert me. I can't give you the heart you think. Time to say goodbye to tyrant and table. To tyrant and table.
Wonderful stuff, Emma. Well done. Welcome back. That was fabulous. Just take the microphone down to Bix, please. We're going to bring Chelsea up now, and I'm just going to, and Mr. Juan, and more people to thank. Mr. Wayne Elliott down the front here, he and I arrived in 2008. We've been here quite a while, and he's come along to... he's the head of music in the elementary school, and he's come along to support tonight. And to our head of strings, Mr. Juan, who last year was one of the only teachers who could really do the hours of work. And we did some great digital productions because he had that technology and he had the skills. And we're finally open up. Our instrumental program is now fully open again. So we're building numbers, which is, yeah, it's worth a round of applause. I didn't look at the stats, but pre-COVID we had about 500 students a week. We're not there yet, but we know that we've got the ability to build that up. Our ensembles in the secondary school are reopening. Now, just before Jar of Hearts, Turning Tables, we're now going to that roller coaster I said we were on with Love and Loss. And before we listen to Chelsea's song, and I say that with... platonic love, Chelsea, because it is a very powerful song that she's going to sing, and it's about loss in life. And I have to say, she made me cry the other day when she did it in class, because that's the power of music sometimes. But I'd like to share something super positive. Fidaus, our theatre manager, well, actually more his wife, managed to produce a brand new perfect baby girl called Inura a couple of weeks ago. So I just want to congratulate our theatre manager, Fidaus. And just selfishly, mate, I was counting down the days of your paternity leave before to make sure you were back in time for tonight, which is wonderful. And then he went and got COVID last week and had to do the testing for that. So we welcome you back and congratulations for that perfect moment in your lives. So, Chelsea, let's bring you onto stage. You have your microphone.
I picked up your...
Oh, sorry.
I picked up your shirt this morning. I don't know why. I don't know why. Mr. Reynolds said to say hello. I started to cry. I started to cry. Every place we've ever walked in, everywhere we talked, I miss you. You'll never leave my mind. So much of you is left behind. You. Unfinished conversations we used to have still speak to me, and I write you letters every day that I'll never send and you'll never see. All this wishful thinking gets me nowhere. I can't stay, and all my heart is broken. It keeps breaking every day. You took my heart with you. Took my dreams with you. I keep thinking that you'll be calling. Everyone says that it's all in my head, and I can't accept it yet. I'm not ready to just give in. I know that I can't live in this pain with these feelings of regret. I can't comprehend this and pretend that I don't care. Any place I wanna be, I wanna see you there.
Yeah, there's not a lot to say after that, except that that was a really powerful performance, Chelsea. I think she deserves another round of applause for that. And you got me at the modulation. It just evokes a lot of feelings, that song. So that will be a great HSC performance. We're looking at some good marks for that later in the year. Let's keep the focus here. So we're going to bring another one of our olden days people up, Maddie, to sing a classic bit of dad rock for us, or dad ballad, I suppose it is. I'm not even sure if you're allowed to use that term. there was something else I wanted to say. Thank you to the students who have supported your friends and to the Year 9 elective kids that have come back and you're building the vibe of the music village again. And I said to the students who are performing, you could phone a friend and get them to fill out the survey, expecting that they just wouldn't get their act together or they possibly were too worried about it. And here you have all these people, these wonderful peers of yours that have come to support them. So well done, guys. And now let's bring Maddie onto stage to sing. Whew, sorry, I'm still getting over Chelsea. Songbird. So our very own songbird, Maddie Higgs. Thank you, Maddie. That was wonderful. And you remembered all the words. And I just remembered Maddie singing in the elementary presentation day many, many years ago as one of the soloists in the mass singing. among other things. And as a music educator, in, you know, forget COVID, as a music educator, it's so heartwarming to see your little ones grow up and become these young adult adolescents and see them blossom as musicians. So, Maddie, that was a delight to listen to. And, you know, one of the positive things that's come out of all this challenge that we have, Jake, come on up and start setting up, is that the technology has improved so that we can broadcast this out into our community and the wider community. So I think that the Hazelwood family, you've got grandparents perhaps dialing in. I just, on a whim, want to shout out to my daughter Jess, who's 22 and sitting at university watching this. And, you know, that couldn't have happened pre-COVID. So, hey, Jess, I'm sure you're really embarrassed at me saying that. And while we're on Big Marker and broadcasting things, I'd like to thank Scarlett and Karina from our communications team, who have done a great job, and they've also got more dates in the diary for the next two events that we've got this term, and we've got plans for other events next term as well. So I'm going to welcome Jake now. Jake is going to continue our theme of love and relationships with a searingly hot tango on the guitar. So please transport yourself wherever you need to be while you listen to this tango. Thank you, Jake. Please welcome him. Jake, did you bow? Are you sure? Did he bow? He bowed. Okay, well done. That was a fabulous performance. And again, Jake's started in Year 11 HSC Music, and the passion is just oozing out of him. And, you know, he's going to really develop as a classical guitarist. And he's already in the soul band. He came to our new men's vocal group that we've started. And that's a wonderful thing. Thank you so much, Jake. Well done. And one last thank you, but certainly not least, and someone who always has our back. In fact, she's really missed the job of going to the nurses to get the first aid kits in the last 2 years, is our wonderful Mrs. Davis, our instrumental coordinator, who has done so much to make this happen tonight. So thank you, Naomi. So we've come to our final performance this evening. Thank you for coming along. I think I've covered everybody in the thank yous. it's a bit of a pilot, and we'll keep this going and see what we can do. We have another recital in 2 weeks' time that will be for younger students in the secondary, and we have a little bit of a dabble with a second Mo, the student rock concert later in the term. So a busy term ahead, but a musical one, which is lovely. Now, Nick Barg. I've crossed out the old Nick, but I found I'm not very good at cleaning up, and I was going through some folders today and I found this merit award that I was supposed to give you in December of 2020 from Miss Burke for being an integral part of the vocal ensemble's first virtual choir, an endeavour which took courage, patience, independence, and an exceeding level of musicianship. And thank God you're now on stage with a microphone in your hand and a negative test and a song in your heart. So I'll give this to you afterwards. So let's finish with a little bit of Gershwin, a happy way to finish. Thank you so much for coming, parents and friends and peers. And let's keep moving forward through this. Thank you so much.
The concert was over at Carnegie Hall. The maestro took bow after bow. He said, "My dear friends, I have given my all. Sorry, it's all over now." When from the balcony way up high, there suddenly came a mournful cry. "Oh, Mr. Paganini, please play my rhapsody. And if you cannot play it, won't you sing it? And if you can't sing it, you simply have to. Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. Listen, Paganini, we breathlessly await your masterful baton. Go on and swing it. And if you can't swing it, you simply have to. We heard your repertoire, and at the final bar, we greeted you with a round of applause. But what a great ovation in your interpretation of "I Never Cared Much for Moonlit Skies, I Never Blinked Back at Fireflies" would do. So Paganini, don't you be a meanie. What have you up your sleeve? Go on and swing it. And if you can't sing it, you simply have to. Listen, Paganini, please play my rhapsody. And if you cannot play it, won't you sing it? If the boys is bopping, ain't no need to stop it. Listen, Paganini, we breathlessly await your masterful baton. Go on and sling it. The boys is bopping, ain't no need to stop it.